CashFx was a Panama-based Ponzi scam that was started in mid-2019 by Huascar Lopez from the Dominican Republic and Ron Pope from the United States. The scheme offered investors returns of 1-2% per day. The returns were said to be generated by trading on the foreign exchange market, but in fact existing investors were simply being paid from funds generated from new investor deposits. CashFX started having payment problems around October 2021, and the last regular payments to investors were made March 2022, indicating total collapse of the scheme. Before collapsing, CashFX had over 350,000 investors worldwide and was the subject of 33 securities fraud warnings. It had become one of the largest online Ponzi scams in the world, generating over $2 billion. So, who are the five main characters involved in this massive Ponzi scam? Huascar Lopez, CEO. Prior to CashFX, Dominican Republic citizen Huascar Lopez had been involved in various marketing and scammy-style projects and crypto deals. He met Ron Pope when they were promoting a small holiday marketing idea called My Fun Life. Huascar had no background in Forex trading. Huascar was a charismatic and charming frontman but also had no ability to program a sophisticated Ponzi scam. That's where Ron Pope came in. Ron Pope, CashFX system programmer. Ron is a US citizen and runs a marketing company called The Conversion Pros. Huascar pitched the CashFX Ponzi scam idea to Ron, and Ron programmed the CashFX system, also known as the CashFX back office. Ron probably thinks he is going to get away with this scam, saying that he simply programmed the system. Well, not so fast, Ron. Blockchain evidence shows that CashFX was programmed as a Ponzi scam. Money flowing into the system was routed straight back out to pay earlier investors, and Ron Pope is on record admitting that he programmed that system. In order to jumpstart the scam, Ron called his friend Justin Halliday and suggested Justin get involved. Justin Halliday, co-lead promoter. When Ron Pope called Florida resident Justin Halliday about the CashFX scam idea, Justin was still promoting the Malaysia-based cloud token Ponzi scam. Justin was enthusiastic about the idea and brought on board his notorious Ponzi scamming friend Luigi Bruni. Luigi Bruni, co-lead promoter. Since leaving a car dealership some 10 or more years ago, Canadian Luigi Bruni has jumped from Ponzi scam to Ponzi scam. When fellow cloud token scammer Justin Halliday contacted him about CashFX, Luigi immediately jumped on board. Luigi and Justin embarked on a world tour to promote CashFX. Within months, they had generated tens of thousands of investors from the Philippines, South Africa, Nigeria, and Europe. It was like a dangerous version of the movie Dumb and Dumber. John Kinnear, marketing director. Canadian John Kinnear was the marketing face for the CashFX Ponzi scam. John is a talented speaker and gave the scam the air of legitimacy it required to convince hundreds of thousands of people that what they were investing in was real. John had been involved in a number of Ponzi scams before CashFX, including Cloud Token and UniFII. John made regular videos promoting the scam and reassuring increasingly nervous investors, but when the scheme collapsed, John stopped making his videos. He hasn't been seen online since. So now you know who created CashFX, you are probably wondering where your money went. Well, CashFX was a Ponzi scam, so the money you put in was largely paid out to those who got in before you. The higher you were in the pyramid, the more money you made. For example, blockchain records indicate that Justin Halliday received around $10 million. In the last year of its existence, with new signups dropping, it was time for the big payday for Huascar and his gang. Blockchain records show that the people in charge of CashFX sent over $150 million to a Binance wallet to be cashed out. You heard that right. They stole $150 million. Blockchain records show that new members from around the world were still sending around $5 million per week to Panama, and most of that money was being directly stolen. If you were a victim of the CashFX Ponzi scam, we urge you to report the people mentioned in this video to the authorities. US authorities treat frauds of this magnitude very seriously. The crimes that these five could be charged with include securities fraud, wire fraud, tax evasion, and non-disclosure of foreign bank accounts. The names are listed below. Remember, these fraudsters will get away with it if honest people, like you, do nothing. The best things in life.